Just as President Obama arrived, Copenhagen was collapsing. Far from fretting over a promised crackdown on fossil fuels, the man representing the countries with the most to lose was leaving early with nothing to worry about.
I'm sure there will be nothing from this conference. As I've been here 3-4 days, there's a lot of misunderstanding, a lot of conflict here and there.
After 2 weeks of haggling in Denmark and 2 years of negotiations in the run-up, more than 100 world leaders looked far from cutting a deal, until talks moved to the back rooms, where out of the spotlight, President Obama brokered an accord with China, Brazil, India, and South Africa to cut emissions and give aid to developing countries to deal with climate change.
It will not be legally binding, but what it will do is allow for each country to show to the world what they're doing, and there will be a sense on the part of each country that we're in this together.
As you can see, far from everyone is happy with the deal. The commitments fall short of saving the planet, lack the teeth of international law, and were hardly negotiated out in the open.
President Obama says it is a first step, will eventually become binding, and is all that could have been accomplished. He's not the only one to say that.
I think we've seen the limits of the United Nations process. It's incredibly difficult to get 192 countries to get to consensus on anything. And the other thing is, this is really an 80-20 problem. There are 20 countries responsible for more than 80% of the emissions. Let's get those countries in a room on a periodic basis, as we do with the major economies forum, hammer out the solutions, and then implement the policies on a domestic level.
One negotiator said the text is hardly a triumph. There's a long road ahead. Ryan Chilcote, Bloomberg News, Copenhagen.